A lot of people may well see this particular gentleman as someone who makes an appearance either in a supporting or non-supporting role in many of the poems that I do. The truth is that the politics that we discuss are not partisan politics in terms of Democrat or Republican. I am a member of the Common Sense Party. And for the longest count of a time, I have felt as though people who said that they did not care anything about politics or were not interested in it were making a political statement in and of itself. The new poetry that evolved in our society concerned the fact that folks wanted to use both words that people could understand as well as talk about ideas that people could understand. One such poem, at least an early poem of ours that went in that direction, concerned the fact that millions and millions of dollars are continually sent into outer space while we continue to face the same problems here on the ground. The poem said, "A rat done bit my sister Nell with Whitey on the moon, and her face and arms began to swell, and Whitey's on the moon. I can't pay no doctor bills, but Whitey's on the moon. 10 years from now, I'll be paying still while Whitey's on the moon. You know the man just upped my rent last night? 'Cause Whitey's on the moon. No hot water, no toilets, and no lights, but Whitey's on the moon. I wonder why he's upping me. 'Cause Whitey's on the moon. I was already giving him 50 a week, and now Whitey's on the moon. Taxes taking my whole damn check. The junkies make me a nervous wreck. The price of food is going up. And as if all that crap wasn't enough, a rat done bit my sister Nell with Whitey on the moon. Her face and arms began to swell, and Whitey's on the moon. Was all that money I made last year for Whitey on the moon? How come I ain't got no money here? Whitey's on the moon. You know I just about had my fill of Whitey on the moon. I think I'll send these doctor bills, airmail special, to Whitey on the moon." We have done a number of songs, we hope, that have strengthened our connection with the third world, because it seems as though oftentimes there are attempts to split us up, divide and conquer, keep us at odds with one another so that we never define the things that we have in common. But we have more things in common than we do that separate us. The song that we wrote was about people who are sometimes referred to as aliens, or worse still, illegal aliens. And we have insisted that this is to differentiate them from folks who have come here from Mars legally. And these are folks who in our song come across near Tijuana or the Rio Grande. They're brought into this country by coyotes, people smugglers. They're forced to pay mordida, the bribes, to keep from being turned into immigration. And when they do that, they're called pollos, chickens, ripe for the plucking. Sometimes these folks come into this country with only their dreams of doing better and the clothes they got on their back. And this is what we have in common with them. The reason we get up every day and decide to try it again is because we have dreams of doing better. The song is about holding on to your dreams. We call the song Alien. We got a little something to help us out with the salsa scene. Mi amigo de la calle, dígame otra vez, uno más, por favor, toma otra vez con la ritma. Midnight near the border, trying to cross the Rio Grande, running with coyotes, the weather streets are paved with gold, diving underwater when you hear the helicopters, knowing it's all better, less than worthless if you run into